Johnny Gaudreau trying to bang it in off Bishop, and it comes back to Gaudreau. Another bang shot, didn't quite work. Gaudreau stick handling in a fumble, makes a pass to the slot, tipped away. Look up, Radulov on a break. Giordano hustling back, takes him now. Played out front, and that'll be a penalty shot. Radulov with 20.9 seconds left in overtime as he got in behind Mark Giordano, who had to take him down. This game's had a bit of everything.
Johnny Gaudreau twice trying to bank it in off Ben Bishop from behind the net. And just what an effort by Giordano to track down Radulov.
Giordano playing Radulov.
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
Frederick Lefouillet right there to make the call. Let's take a look at it.
Yes. You be the judge at home. Well, he does take him down. That would be pretty difficult not to call.
David Rittich doesn't seem rattled. Never does.
No, he never does.
Radulov. Overtime penalty shot. Working in on Rittich. Stop by Rittich! And is he excited or what? And there's the happiest man in the building, Mark Giordano.
Yes. I love Rittich and the way in which he shows his emotion. I'm a little surprised by Radulov. There wasn't much in that. He was just going to try and rip it past Rittich, but there didn't even appear to me like there was very much deception with that release.
And it's Tyler Seguin.
Shooting first for your Dallas Stars.
First for Dallas. And here he goes. In on Rittich. Seguin slows down. Scores!
What a beautiful set of hands by Seguin. Just waits and waits and waits. And just over the goalie stick and through the legs. Beautiful shot.
Sean Monahan, first shooter for the Flames. Scores! And he goes blocker side on Bishop.
And although it wasn't the shot we were looking for, it's similar in which he waits. And then finally when he spots Bishop to go down, that's an incredibly difficult shot to stop.
So Radulov just got stopped on a penalty shot in overtime. Comes in on Rittich again. And Rittich stops him again, this time with the old poke check. Knocked it away. Radulov tried to make a move this time instead of shooting, and Rittich able to shut him down.
And he got in a little too tight on the backhand, and then he just ran out of room, and David Rittich was just able to use the stick and knock the puck into the corner.
Matthew Tkachuk. In on Bishop. Stopped by Bishop, trying to go 5-0. Bishop able to shut the door.
Nice save by Bishop. Under control. Read that all the way.
Jamie Benn has to score. Rittich's got a chance to win it with a save. Pardon me. As Benn comes in, Rittich able to shut him down. So we have one more shooter. A little premature.
At least, right?
Nice stop by Rittich on Ben.
Absolutely. Ben was trying to get the puck to settle down, and then Rittich took away the 5-hole.
So Johnny Gaudreau with a chance to win it. Gaudreau for the win. Scores! What a move by Johnny Gaudreau! And the Flames complete the comeback with a 3-2 overtime win in a shootout against the Dallas Stars.
And there's that skating ability by Johnny Gaudreau with those edges, the ability to change direction on a dime. And Ben Bishop, I'm sure, thought he had him. But Johnny able to go quickly to his right at the very last second and slide that backhand into the net for the Flames' victory.
Well, the terrific start to the season continues for Johnny Gaudreau as he gets the shootout winner, and Rittich with two saves. allows Gaudreau to do this to Ben Bishop.
Wow, there's that edge work I was talking about. Yep. That's crazy. The ability to move to his right, the lateral ability to change direction like that from Johnny Gaudreau, that's a special talent.
You know, Kelly, as great a year as the Flames had last season, they were 0-4 on shootouts. This is their first shootout win since November 5th of 2017. And to do it with a third period comeback.